Now that we've finished building our voluntary turnover report, let's build a report that will show the voluntary turnover forecast for the next 5 years. So to begin, now that I want to build the report based on occupation. So we saw this in the last video, is the headcount history. What I really care about is grabbing the occupations and the headcount. And this number here is 3217. We've seen that. We're seeing it here in this report. We've seen it many times. We saw this when we started building the corporate diversity and the profile report. This is headcount. So what I'm going to do is similar to the last time. I'm going to move our copy. I'm going to create a copy, put into a new workbook. All right. So from here, all I need is that one column, right? And this is, we're going to call this headcount. So right now I'm not actually doing the forecast. I'm just setting up the report and incorporate the voluntary turnover forecast into this report because I will want to report it based on occupation. All right. So from here, we're going to go back to the terminated employee database, and we have the numbers already from when we built the voluntary turnover report. So we're going to grab these numbers once again. Actually, I'm going to grab all of this, put into a new sheet, and paste as values. All right, so I'm going to use this just as a kind of like a scrap sheet of paper here. Let's move this over. Okay, now that we're taking a look at it, we have the voluntary turnover, double checking, yeah, by fiscal year. And what we need to do, and we're going to do very simple forecasting here. This is called straight line forecasting. What that basically means is let's take a look at the past and find out what's the average number of people that have left us each year over the last 4 years. Once we have that average per year number, we're going to multiply it by 5 to see 5 years into the future. All right, so from here, this is going to be the average. I'm going to write this at average number of people who have left us each year over the last 4 years. Okay, horrible title. The point of this is not to focus on the description, but really just to make sure that we understand the numbers that are going to be appearing within this particular column. All right, so Excel has an average formula. Well, we could just use the average formula, right, across all 4 years. Well, if we do this, I want to bring your attention to an issue. Oh, before I do that, you'll notice there's a little green symbol up here in the arrow in the top left-hand corner, and a little exclamation mark in a triangle. This basically says it's an error, or it's a warning, not an error, it's a warning saying the formula omits the adjacent cells. What does that mean? Well, we took the average across these four, but we have this one here in column F also attached. It's just asking us, did we make a mistake? Did we forget about it? And we didn't. So I'm going to just ignore that and copy this all the way down. So our total is 142. But when we look at it occupation by occupation, even though the formula has worked, it's wrong. Let's take a look at analysts, for example. We had 12 leave in 2018, 12 in 2019, and nobody left in 2020 or 2021. So how can this be correct? We're saying on average, we see 12 analysts leave us each and every year. So what's going on? Well, when we do an average, the fact that these two cells are blank, it's as if Excel is only looking at these two and ignores the other two over here. So where it's blank, it ignores it. So if I put in a zero, watch the 12 change. And now it's more appropriate. It's looking at six people on average every single year. Okay, so the average formula, I'd be cautious of that. So then if you want to use it, you have to remember I got to put zeros in all the blanks. What if you do it for each one, but for example, you forget about it in logistics? So here's what I recommend. Instead of trying to remember to put in zeros in all the blank cells, go old school. Either you can take the formula, sum of these four data points, and divide by four, Or, since we have the grand total, we'll take the grand total divide by 4. So it's interesting how the grand total doesn't change. However, the individual occupations do. Here's something else I actually want to point out before I do that. If I select these cells, what's the total sum? 151.833. That does not match this number here. So right away, I know there's an issue. So that's a quick sanity check. Add up the averages. It doesn't match. There's a problem. Okay. So let's take the grand total, divide by 4, copy it down. And now if I take the individual occupations, look in the status bar, 142.5, it matches. All right, just a little extra trick to confirm that the numbers are correct. So now that we know the average number of people that left us each year over the last 4 years, let's do a 5-year forecast. All right, so for here, I'm going to take the average number of people who left us each year as observed over the last 4 years, multiply it by 5. And copy it down. So we see that 712 or 713 people we think are going to leave us over the next 5 years because they're choosing to go work somewhere else. All right, so let's bring this information into the other report that we're building to get a full picture. So from here, I'm going to grab this data and paste it as values. Okay. So similar to the voluntary turnover report, now I'm going to match up everything. So I'm going to bring all this data down. Well, I'll keep doing it so everything matches. Now, for some of you that might be more familiar with Excel, you might be thinking, this seems like a real tedious way. There's got to be an easier way. And you're right. And again, we're going to learn these functions after the midterm. And the one that I'm thinking of, that you might be thinking of as well too, is VLOOKUP, or alternatively, XLOOKUP, that can take a look at all the data and bring it in without having to adjust the data here. Perfect. So now I can delete this column. There we go. And I'll call this historical, maybe something like historical voluntary turnover. Sorry, it's harder for me to type. I'm getting more spelling mistakes, so I have to lean over from where the microphone is. That's why it's I'm making all these mistakes here. There we go. I'll merge and center. I don't need the grand total anymore. There we go. And maybe I'll call this something a little bit better. Average per year. There we go. And apply sort of similar language here. 5-year forecast. Okay. Now I'm going to have another column, percent of, what's it called, headcount. So I've got my forecast. This is the 712, right? Over 5 years, we've made that forecast. Now as a percent of current headcount, let's do it this way. We'll take 5-year forecast divided by current headcount and change it to percent format. So we're saying that 34% of all current accountants are going to leave in the next 5 years to go work somewhere else. So now I'll copy this down. There we are. So 22% of all employees are forecasted to leave due to voluntary turnover over the next 5 years. Okay, so I'm not going to spend time on formatting here, but we want to add some more insight. So this is one view of people choosing to leave us. But last week we talked about the number of people who are choosing to leave us due to retirements. So let's put together the retirement forecast for 5 years and the voluntary turnover forecast for 5 years to get a picture of how many people are choosing to leave us over the next 5 years between those two categories. So where do we get this information? Well, we used the retirement calculator and using current headcount and incorporated that information by age and age grouping. We grouped the age for under 51, put in the retirement calculator, and got a result. I'll pull up that file right now. Okay, so from here, I have my payroll information. I'll take age, put it into columns, and this should be a refresher. For us, we'll take 19 to age 50. Right click and choose group and take age out. So now, oh, I've got my 55 plus. Let me just ungroup that. Here we are. So now I've got the data in the pivot table for headcount, and look at that 3217. We've seen that number again and again. So I'll copy this current headcount data through my retirement calculator and paste his values. And it only goes up to age 65, a double check, 3,217. This is really small. For total headcount, that makes sense. We'll go to results, and here we are. So out of 3,217 people, current headcount, 737 are planning to retire in the next 5 years, which is 23% of our current staff. All right, so let's incorporate these numbers into our report. Okay, let's put some summary. So we have here, well, retirement 5 year forecast. And how many people were that? Well, let's go back. It was 737. So I'm just going to reference this number and bring it in. Okay, perfect. And let's bring the data over here. Voluntary turnover. Five-year forecast. Well, that number is right over here. And I'll just decrease the decimal, 713. So we'll say, what's the total 5 year retirement plus 5 year voluntary turnover forecast? And it's the 737 plus the 713, 1449. All right, so what is that as a percent of headcount? Well, the 1449 divided by 3217. So 45%, 45.1% of our current headcount as of today will leave over the next 5 years between retirement and voluntary turnover. So at this point, once we created the report and done the professional formatting to make it look nice, we should probably put some commentary. This 45.1%, what are the implications of this number being so high to our company? And for that section, this is where I leave you, and this is for you to put together some thoughts and some ideas of why that number is significant and relevant to the company.